For a starting vector calculus, you must know some of the things like dot product of two vectors v1 and v2. Suppose if there are two vectors v1 and v2, how to take the dot product of v1 and v2. Also, you must know how to expand the determinant. You must know partial differentiation for computing gradient of phi. So many things are there. Now, let us take some problems so that you can understand. Suppose if there is a vector a2i plus 3j plus 4k, a vector b is 6i minus 7j plus 8k is there, then what is the dot product between a and b means? It is denoted by a dot b, that is equal to 2 into 6, that is multiply the corresponding coefficients of I. What is the coefficient of I? 2 here. What is the coefficient of I? 6, 2 into 6 plus coefficient of j? 3, coefficient of j? Minus 7, so 3 into minus 7 plus coefficient of k is 4. Coefficient of k is 8, 4 into 8. So this is the dot product between a and b. Now what is the cross product a cross b? A cross b means first you are writing ijk. Understand? First you are writing ijk. Now first vector is a. So therefore the coefficients of ijk, that is 2, 3, 4. Coefficients of ijk 2, 3, 4. That must be written here as a second row. So here corresponding to b, what is the vector? What is the vector b? 6i minus 7j plus 8k. The coefficients of ijk, that is 6 minus 7, 8. That should be written as the third row. Now I have to expand this determinant. How to expand the determinant? A cross b, that is ijk, is equal to 2ijk, 2, 3, 4, 6 minus 7, 8. How to expand this determinant? Now, let us start like this. First, first, you take the first element i into. Now, this I lies on the first row, first column. So, remove first row, first column. I lies on the first row, first column. So, remove the first row, first column. Then what remains? This 3, 4, minus 7, 8. Similarly, second element of the first row you take and you write minus j. Minus j into this j, always j lies on the first row, remove the first row. It lies on second column. My finger is showing the second column. Remove the second column, first row. So what remains? 2, 4, 6, 8. Next, plus k into it lies on the first row. K lies on first row, so remove first row. This K, it is in third column, remove third column. So what is remaining? K, it is in third column, remove third column. K, it is on first row, remove first row. Then what remains? 2, 3, 6, minus 7. So now, expand this I into. How to expand this 2 cross 2 determinants? I into 3 into 8 minus 4 into minus 7. 4 into this minus 7. Right? Next, minus j into, observe, 2 into 8. 2 into 8 minus this 4 into 6. Right? Similarly, plus k into 2 into minus 7. 2 into minus 7 plus 3 into 2 into minus 7. 2 into minus 7. Plus 3 into 6. So this is how I am expanding this determinant. So remember, for expanding the determinant, always you are removing the first row. For example, you are starting with I, isn't it? You have started with I into. Remove the first row. This I lies on the first column. Remove first column. So when you remove first row and first column, what is remaining? 3, 4, minus 7, 8. I have written that. Next, minus j into. J lies on the first row, remove J. J lies on second column, so what is remaining? 2, 6, 4, 8. 2, 6, 4, 8, observe, I have written that. Similarly, K lies on the first row and third column. Remove first row and third column, what is remaining? 2, 3, 6, minus 7. Now, expansion means 3 into 8 minus 4 into minus 7. So, just simplify this. This is the expansion of the determinant.